ready? Start. The above provision was inserted by Act 21 of 1996 with effect from 1st August 1996. Stop. It is common ground between senior counsel and the Attorney General for India that prior to 1st August 1996, there was no bar on the number of seats which a candidate could contest in the course of one election, be it for parliamentary or state legislative assembly constituencies. Stop. Parliament has stepped in to provide that a candidate cannot contest more than two seats simultaneously in one and the same election. Stopera. The issue which has been raised by the petitioner pertains to the legislative domain. Stop. Undoubtedly, comma, where a candidate contests more than one seat simultaneously in the course of the same general election, comma, one seat has to be vacated if the candidate succeeds in both the electoral contests. Stop. That necessitates a by-election. Stop. The petitioner has highlighted the fact that this involves a drain on the public exchequer. Stop. The issue, comma, however, comma, is whether this by itself would result in the invalidation of a statutory provision. Stop. Para. A statutory provision can be challenged before the court either on the ground that it has been made by a legislature which lacks legislative competence to enact a law, or on the ground that there is a violation of a fundamental rights in part 3rd of the Constitution. Stop. The former is not an issue. Stopera. Permitting a candidate to contest from more than one seat in a parliamentary election or at an election to the state legislative assembly is a matter of legislative policy. Stop. It is a matter pertaining to legislative policy since, comma, ultimately, comma, parliament determines whether political democracy in the country is furthered by granting a choice such as is made available by section 33 subsection 7 of the Act of 1951. Stop. Para. A candidate who contests from more than one seat may do so for a variety of reasons, not just bearing on the uncertainty which the candidate perceives of an election result. Stop. There are other considerations which weigh in the balance in determining whether this would restrict the course of electoral democracy in the country. Stop. This is a matter where Parliament is legitimately entitled to make legislative choices and enact or amend legislation. Stop. The Law Commission and the Election Commission may at the material time have expressed certain viewpoints. Stop. Whether they should be converted into a mandate of the law depends on the exercise of parliamentary sovereignty. in enacting legislation.